And Father God, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray, come and speak your word. Come and teach us your word. We bless you and we honor you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. Once again, God bless you all for watching. God bless you. Today, I want to share with you about the Holy Spirit, the beautiful, mighty third person of Trinity. We're going to continue where we left off last week. Last week, we spoke about the Holy Spirit being a person. And today, I want to take a little step further. So if you have your Bible, go with me to the Gospel of John, chapter 14. The Gospel of John, chapter 14. In Jesus' name. And I want to start from the verse 15. Verse 15. And this is our Lord Jesus Christ speaking here. Our Lord Jesus Christ speaking. The Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 15. I'm going to read from verse 15 to verse 18. Jesus said, "If you love me, keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he will give you another helper, that he may abide with you forever. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him." You know him. You see, you notice how Jesus is calling the Holy Spirit he and him? Guys, take a look at the verse 17. If you have your Bible, look at it. Look at how Jesus is referring to the Holy Spirit. He says, "I'll pray to the Father and he will give you another helper." So here clearly, you see the Holy Spirit is a person. Because Jesus said, "Another helper like me." So he's a person. And now when you move on to verse 17, he says, "The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees him." Jesus refers to the Holy Spirit as a him. Him. So he's a person, nor knows him. You see that? He's a person. "But you know him, for he dwells with you and he will be in you." So clearly, the Holy Spirit is a person. But today, I want to focus on the Holy Spirit. I'm reading from Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 15 to 18. That's what I just read. Verse 15 to 18. The last verse, verse 18, it says, "I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. I will come to you." So the Holy Spirit, he's with us. If you read the scriptures that we just read, the Holy Spirit, he is with us to convict us for salvation. He's with us to convict us for salvation. The Holy Spirit is everywhere. He's on the earth. He is on the earth right now. He's everywhere at the same time. And he's with us to convict us for salvation. But then Jesus took it a step further. Jesus said the Holy Spirit will come in us. He's with us and then you abide in us. You abide in us. So this is what Jesus is talking about, the conversion, the new birth experience. The Holy Spirit will come in you when you are born again. Jesus is talking about being born again. When you're born again, the Holy Spirit dwells in you. And so every believer, every true believer has the Holy Spirit indwelling them. This is separate from the baptism of the Holy Spirit. This scripture is not talking about the baptism of the Holy Spirit. He's talking about the person of the Holy Spirit. The person of the Holy Spirit. And that person of the Holy Spirit lives in you, if you're born again, lives in me as a child of God. Every true believer of God has the Holy Spirit dwelling in them. This is separate from the baptism of the Holy Spirit. You're talking about the person of the Holy Spirit coming to live in the bodies of the true people of God. Amen. And Jesus said he is with us and then he'll be in us. But if you look at the verse 16, it says, "I pray the Father will give you another helper." Another helper. Another helper. So I want to take a look at that word, okay? Another helper. We want to talk about that word helper for a second. The helper here, in order for us to understand, I want to read the Amplified Classic. The Amplified Classic, the same scripture, John chapter 14, verse 16, from the Amplified Classics, it helps us to understand the meaning of the word helper. The word helper here is the Greek word called Parakletos. Parakletos. And it simply means one who's called to our side, or the comforter, or advocate, or intercessor, or the standby. But I want to throw a little light on it for us to really understand it, okay? So let's go to the Amplified Classic. The Amplified Classic, John chapter 14, verse 16. From the Amplified Classic, it explains what the word helper means. Helper, the comforter. So in verse 16, it says, I will ask the Father, he will give you another comforter. And that word comforter is the same as the counselor, same as helper, same as intercessor, same as the advocate, same as the strengthener, same as the standby. So you see the meaning of that word. That word has so many meanings. So the Holy Spirit, he's our comforter, he's our helper, he's our counselor, he's our intercessor, he's our advocate, he's our strengthener, he's our standby friend. The Holy Spirit, simply put, he's our everything. The Holy Spirit, he is our everything. And if you're born again, the Holy Spirit, he is our everything. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. So the Holy Spirit, he's our intercessor. And not only that, he's our helper. Isn't that amazing that God has saved us by his precious blood? He has saved you and I by the blood that Jesus shed on Calvary, but he did not leave us. This is why Jesus said, I will not leave you as orphans, but I will send you another helper like me. You see, when Jesus was on earth, the disciples always went to Jesus. The disciples always went to Jesus when they need help. They went to Jesus when they had a problem. They went to Jesus when someone needed a healing. We went to Jesus when someone needed a miracle. When they were with Jesus, the people that need help to Jesus. They always went to Jesus. And Jesus said, I'm leaving, but I'll send you one like me. So let me ask you a question. Now that Jesus is gone, Jesus is seated at the right hand of the Father. So who do you think we should go for help now? Who do you think we should go when we have a problem? Who do you think we should go to when we are struggling, when we need help, when we need comfort, when we need advice? Who should we go to? I think this portion of scripture makes it very clear to us that Jesus wants us to go to the Holy Spirit. You see, the Holy Spirit has come to take the place of Jesus. Jesus Christ is seated at the right hand of the Father, and we, the children of God, he is our everything. So we must go to the Holy Spirit. Therefore, we must get to know the Holy Spirit. This is why I started last week by teaching you that the Holy Spirit is a person. Because you cannot go to him if he's not a person. And now that we know he's a person, we can go to him with our cries. We can go to him with our burdens. We can go to him with our problems. We can go to him with our struggles. Whatever's troubling us, we can go to the Holy Spirit. Because Jesus said he is our helper. In other words, Jesus says, stop crying. Stop looking to yourself. Stop seeking help from everywhere else. And look to the Holy Spirit. Beloved of God, the Holy Spirit is here for you and I. The Holy Spirit, he's waiting for you to call on him for help. And for many of us, we are ignoring the Holy Spirit. Many of us, we are looking to different sources. But Jesus said, look to the Holy Spirit for help. The time has come for us to start talking to the Holy Spirit. We have to talk to the Holy Spirit. We have to call on him for help. We have to call on him for advice. We have to call on him for comfort. Whatever it is that we believe in God for, we must do it through the Holy Spirit. For he's on earth with us. Jesus is seated at the right hand of the Father, interceding for us. But the Holy Spirit is on earth for you and I to help us. So let's get to know the Holy Spirit and allow the Holy Spirit to help our life make easy. He'll make our life so much easier if we get to know him and we begin to have a fellowship with him. For he's a helper. He helps us to pray. He helps us to read the word. He helps us to live for Jesus. He helps us to witness. He helps us to do everything in a Christian. Listen, in a Christian life, without the help of the Holy Spirit, we will sink. Without the help of the Holy Spirit, we will fall flat on our face. But the Holy Spirit helps us to do all the things that God has called us to do. He helps us to do everything that Jesus has called us to do. The Holy Spirit helps us to do it. He helps us to witness. He helps us to pray, to read His word, to live for Jesus, and have the life of Christ in us. Isn't that amazing what God has done for us? Let's get to know the Holy Spirit. Let's get to know the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name. And in John chapter 14, in John 14, 26, in John 14, 26, Jesus said this, "But the Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, He will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all things that I said to you." Did you hear that? It says the Holy Spirit will teach us all things. So when we read the word and we don't understand, we must ask the Holy Spirit. And not only that, everything in our lives that we need teaching, we need to be taught how to be parents, how to be leaders, how to be husbands, wives, in everything we do, in all things, the Holy Spirit will teach us. So in your business, ask the Holy Spirit for wisdom. In your marriage, ask the Holy Spirit to show you how to be a good wife, a good husband, or how to be a good children, or a good student, good business owner, whatever you find yourself. The Bible says the Holy Spirit will teach us all things. He's the helper. He teaches us all things. Maybe you're struggling today. Maybe you're going through some things. You don't know your way out. Have you asked the Holy Spirit? Have you asked the Holy Spirit to help you? He will teach you all things. Begin to talk to the Holy Spirit. Ask Him to help you. He will. Because Jesus said He will teach us all things. All things. No limits. No limits. Whatever we believe in God for, the Holy Spirit is here to teach us all things. And not only that, He'll bring into remembrance all things that Jesus has said to us. He'll bring into remembrance in the mighty name of Jesus. Isn't that amazing? He is powerful. Let's get to know the Holy Spirit. In John chapter, this was John 14, 26. John 14, 26. Now listen to John 15, 26. John 15, 26. Jesus said the same thing. "But when the Helper comes," Jesus said the same thing. "When the Helper comes, whom I shall send you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, He will testify of me." That the Holy Spirit speaks of Jesus. He speaks of Jesus. The Holy Spirit speaks of Jesus. Isn't that amazing? He speaks of Jesus. Glory to God. You see, the Holy Spirit, He's the intercessor that works within us to comfort us and help us. The Holy Spirit is the intercessor that works within us to comfort us and helps us. And then let's look at Romans chapter 8, verse 26. Romans 8, 26. We see more of the works of the Holy Spirit. Romans 8, 26. The Bible says, "Likewise," that was John 15, 26. It was John 14, 26. John 15, 26. Now I'm going to read from Romans chapter 8, verse 26. "Likewise, the Spirit also helps us in our weakness." The Holy Spirit helps us in our weakness. "For we do not know what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit Himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered." Did you hear that? The Holy Spirit intercedes for us. "Now He who searches the heart knows what the mind of the Spirit is, because He makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God." According to the will of God. The Holy Spirit makes intercession for us. As we pray, the Holy Spirit begins to intercede for us. For we don't even know how to pray. Without the Holy Spirit, we don't even know how to pray. But with the Holy Spirit help, we pray the prayers that brings glory and honor to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. There are two intercessors. There are two intercessors. There are two intercessors. Jesus Christ, our Lord Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. There are two intercessors. the Holy Spirit, and our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, our Lord Jesus Christ, intercede for us before the Father so we can be accepted. Our Lord Jesus intercedes for us. He's interceding right now at the right hand of the Father as the faithful high priest. He's interceding for us so we can be accepted before the Father. And the Holy Spirit, he intercedes through us to comfort us and to help us and to accomplish the purpose of God. So the two paracletes, the Lord Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, these are the true intercessors. So true intercession, we talk about intercessory prayers. True intercession is from the Lord Jesus Christ and the precious Holy Spirit. Jesus intercede for you and I before the Father so that we can be accepted by the Father. And then the Holy Spirit intercede through us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And when he uses our vessel to pray the prayers that bring glory to God and to accomplish the work of God. But the two paracletes work together in perfect harmony. The two paracletes, the Holy Spirit and Lord Jesus Christ, they work together in perfect harmony to accomplish the perfect will of God. In Jesus' name. So the Bible tells us, that Jesus Christ, our Lord Jesus Christ, he's seated at the right hand of the Father, right? He's seated at the right hand of the Father, interceding for us. That's what he does. And when you go to 1 John chapter 2, verse 1, it says, "My little children, these things I write to you, so that you may not sin. If anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous." Did you hear that? 1 John chapter 2, verse 1. It says that Jesus Christ is interceding by the Father daily for you and I. So, you know, we have two intercessors in our lives. Our Lord Jesus Christ interceding day and night at the perfect right hand of the Father. Day and night, he's interceding for us. And here on earth, the Holy Spirit is interceding for us and through us. Did you hear that? The Lord Jesus Christ, he is interceding for every true believer at the right hand of the Father constantly. Constantly and consistently, he's a perfect high priest. He's a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek, forever high priest, faithful high priest. He's the mediator, he's the great intercessor forever. Our Lord Jesus Christ sits at the right hand of the Father, interceding for you, interceding for me, so we can be accepted before the Father. This is why the Bible says we are accepted in the Beloved. We are accepted in the Lord Jesus Christ because Jesus Christ is interceding for you and I day and night. So we are accepted in the Beloved. And not only that, the Holy Spirit intercede through us and for us to accomplish the work of God. In Jesus' name, isn't that awesome that we have great help from the Lord himself? We have great help from the Holy Spirit constantly. So there's no way we ought to be defeated. No way. Nobody, no true believer should go down in defeat. Because we have Jesus interceding for us day and night. And we have the Holy Spirit interceding for us day and night. We should never go down in defeat. We should never be defeated. Because there's always constant intercession for us. And all we have to do is surrender and work hand in hand with the Holy Spirit. Begin to talk to the Holy Spirit. Begin to acknowledge his presence. Begin to commune with him. Allow him to lead our lives. Allow him to guide our lives. Surrender our lives completely to him. Depend on him completely. And be obedient. And once we do, we will never go down in defeat. Because he is always interceding for us. And guiding and leading us. But we must surrender our ways, surrender our lives completely to him. daily surrender to the Lord, daily surrender to the Holy Spirit. That is the Christian life, that we are called to live a life of surrender to the Lord Jesus Christ and to the precious Holy Spirit. And when we do, the helper, the comforter, the intercessor, the advocate, the counselor, you begin to work. You begin to work. You begin to work and move so that we will succeed whatever we do. We will succeed wherever we go. We will succeed in whatever endeavor God has given us. But we must work with the Holy Spirit. We must surrender and allow Him to lead us, to lead us, to be the true helper in Jesus' name. So let us stop struggling. Let us stop looking to sources that cannot help us. So many of us are looking to different sources that will never help us. But today we can surrender completely to Jesus, surrender completely to the Holy Spirit, and allow Him to lead our lives to accomplish the purpose of God. In Jesus' name. The time has come to go to the Holy Spirit when we need help, for He is the true helper. Many a times when we go through troubles, we go through struggles, we go through problems, what do? We run quickly to family members. We run to friends. Nothing wrong with that. But we should probably go to God first. We should go to God first. We should go to the intercessor, go to the helper first. And then we can go to secondary sources. They will never disappoint us. They will never let us down. Today, see the Holy Spirit as a helper. Jesus is seated at the right hand of the Father, interceding for you, interceding for me. By the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, He's here right now on earth. And He's closer to you than yourself. The Holy Spirit is more closer to you than yourself. Start talking to Him. Start talking to the Holy Spirit. Start treating Him as a person. Commune with Him and allow Him to change your life and use you for His glory. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's give Jesus the praise. 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 And Father God, we just want to bless your name right now. I just pray, Father, speak to the hearts right now. I'm just praying for you. Holy Spirit, I'm going to pray for you right now, wherever you're watching me from. Just lift your hands and let the Holy Spirit touch you right now. Father, in Jesus' name, visit your people right now. Father God, we repent of our own ways. We repent of our own ways, trying to do things on our own. We surrender completely to your precious Holy Spirit that lead our lives. Lead us in every step of the way. Guide us. Teach us and things that we need to be taught, Father. And help us in every step of the way. We surrender completely to you. We worship you. And we praise your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name. Help us, Lord, to listen to you more. To follow your leadership. In Jesus' name, we praise you and we honor you. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Praise God. God, you're so good. Oh, God.